Good morning, Tabernacle. Welcome to the last Sunday in the month of April. We are so grateful to God. We appreciate all that God has done to and for us to bring us to this moment. Our God is worthy to be praised. And because our God is worthy to be praised, we know we can pray to our God and call on the name of the Lord. So we have names, people on our prayer list that we can take to the God of our salvation. Let us take these names now.
Good morning, everyone, and to everyone, a good morning. We thank you for tuning in to Tabernacle Baptist Church, where we worship God with our whole heart, our mind, our body, and our soul. I heard someone say, "This is the day that the Lord has made, that we will rejoice and be glad in it." And if that is so, give God a hand praise right now, because you are in the land of the living. He had mercy on us once more and again. We woke up with the activities of our limbs. Our problems didn't overtake us. The devil couldn't stop us. The devil's upset because we woke up. Give him praise, give him praise, give him praise. I don't know who's tuning in, but I'm glad that you're tuned in, near and far, from all over the world. Oh, we thank you here at Tabernacle. We believe in worshiping God, and what we stand on is the Word of God. So what would a worship service would be without the Word? And God has given us a Word from 1 John chapter 3. 16 through 24. I'll give you a moment to get your devices, or just let your heart hear from the Word of God. And I'll say it again, 1 John chapter 3, verses 16 through 24. And this is what the Lord says: "By this we know love, because he laid down his life for us. And we also ought to lay down our lives for the brethren. But whoever has this world's goods and sees his brother in need and shuts up his heart from him, how does the love of God abide in him? My little children, let us not love in word or in tongue, but in deed and in truth. And by this we know that we are of the truth and shall assure our hearts before him. For if our heart condemns us, God is greater than our heart and knows all things. Beloved, if our heart does not condemn us, we have confidence towards God. And whatever we ask, we receive from him because we keep his commandments and do those things that are pleasing in his sight. And this is his commandment, that we should believe on the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another as he have gave us commandments. Now, he who keeps his commandments abides in him, and he in him, and by this we know that he abides in us, by the Spirit whom he has given us. That is the word of the Lord. We're going to go before the throne of grace. I don't know what you in need of this morning, but the one who needs to know already knows, and I'm sure he's working it out. Let's go to the throne. Father, in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, dear God, we come before you this morning, dear Lord. I heard someone say, this is the day that the Lord has made. And dear Lord, every day that you make, you crowned it with your glory, dear God. And we thank you, dear God, because you allowed us one more chance to dwell in it, dear God. So we ask that you would have your way in this service, dear God. You know what we are in need of, dear God. You know what needs to be taken from us, dear God. You know us who's fallen down, dear God, because the vicissitudes of life, dear God, are weighing on us, dear God. Dear Lord, we ask that you will come right now and just have your way, dear God. We ask that you will go into the other parts of the world, dear God, that you will go all across the seas, dear God, that you will go to every continent, dear God, because someone in Asia needs you, dear God, someone in Africa needs you, dear Lord, North, South America, dear God, Antarctica, dear God, oh Holy Spirit, Europe, dear God, and Australia, God, dear Lord, I ask that you would touch everywhere, dear God, for the word said that your word travels, dear God, and is swift. Dear God, I ask that it would penetrate, dear God. Dear Lord, you've seen the sick list, and some names did not make the sick list, dear God, but they're calling on you right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask that you would step into the room of the sick one, dear God. I ask that you would step into the room of the despondent one, dear God. I ask that you would step into the room to the one that said, I am done. I'm jumping off this cliff, dear God. Dear Lord, we calling on you right now because you have proven yourself over and over and over and over and over again, dear God. So we know, dear Lord, that you hear the cries of your people. And it may be someone tuning in who don't know you, dear God, but they have nowhere to turn. I ask that you would touch that heart right now, dear God, that you would penetrate it, dear God, that you would send out a rescue mission on their behalf, dear God. And we'll be so careful to say thank you, much obliged, dear God. You've been so good, dear Lord. Some of us prayed last week, dear God, and you answered answered our prayers, dear God. Some of us asked that you would deliver us last week, and we have been delivered, dear God. We thank you, dear God, for your many blessings. We thank you, dear God, that you look past our sins, our iniquities, and our transgressions, dear God. We just come to pause to worship you this morning, dear God, because you are worthy of all the praise, dear God, and that's what we come to do. Praise your holy name. Let the world say, in Jesus' name we praise. Give God some praise right now. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Give him praise. Thank you, Lord. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. Come on, lift up your worship this morning. Hallelujah. Hey. Oh, here we go.
This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. For the Lord our God is strong and mighty. For the Lord our God is mighty in battle.
Sad,
for he has made me once again glad. This is the day.
made. And I will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. And I will rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. God bless you, brothers and sisters. We love you with the love of the Lord. And we are excited that you said, I choose to rejoice. Choose not to be sad. For you have made me once again glad. I love that. I choose to rejoice. To choose is to suggest that there are multiple options on the table. And I come to a place in my mind where I choose that I don't want that option, but I'd rather this option. And so many of you out there, you're choosing to not be sad. You're choosing to not be down. You're choosing to not let life consume you and bring you down. But you choose this day to rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. Amen. God bless you. Thank you again, Music Ministry, for again starting us off right and blessing us in music ministry. Amen. Just a few announcements that we want to share with you. On tomorrow, we will be honoring the life of Minister Bruce Clark. We are so grateful for the many, many, many years of service this man provided to the Tabernacle Baptist Church. And we are so grateful for him. The services will be at 11 o'clock here at the church. Viewing will be from 10 to 11. Amen. It will be a private service for those that are invited by the family, but it will be live streamed. So we will come together and celebrate Bruce's life, both in person and virtually. So again, we thank God for the life of Minister Bruce Clark Sr. Amen, amen, and amen. Brothers and sisters, I cannot let another day go by without taking the time to thank you for the wonderful celebration of 8 years. Last weekend, it was absolutely wonderful. We had a great time. It was so good to see everyone just driving by and just people, you know, you haven't seen in over a year. It was just good to see your faces. I love you and I appreciate you so much for the kind love tokens and just everything you've done to celebrate. I thank my brother, Dr. Willie Dwayne Francois, for coming to share with us in the preaching ministry and the music ministry and everything that just made the weekend wonderful. We are grateful to you. Also, we are looking forward to next weekend, Mission Sunday, here at Tabernacle Baptist Church. I got a new voice for you. Reverend Dr. Leslie Callahan will be preaching. She is dynamic. She is educated. She is passionate about her people. And so she is the perfect person to come and share the gospel of Jesus Christ with us on next Sunday. So we are excited about that. Amen. The Mission Ministry, they are supporting the Ghana Facilities, Salt Pond Municipal Hospital, and Mercy Catholic Women's Center, and they are in need of supplies. So if you want to give to that cause, feel free to see the screen. You can drop it off at the security booth Monday through Thursday, 8 a.m. to 1:30 p.m. Please see all of the items that are needed, and we will send all of these things over to Ghana so that we can help to provide for the needs that are there. Amen. This is wonderful, you guys. My wife, Deborah Jones, is doing something amazing. She's having a facial party for the mothers. Amen. For Mother's Day weekend. And so it's going to be real cool, but you got to register on the TBC website. And once you register, you can pick up the supplies that are going to be needed. And my wife, she does this. This is what she does. She's an esthetician as well as an engineer. And so she's going to have a good time with you guys on Friday, May the 7th. But please register. Please register now on the TBC website. Again, we're grateful to God for the 98th church anniversary. Details are coming. We're going to let you know some more things about it at church conference. Amen. Church conference. So we appreciate God for that. And it looks like I skipped that. My apologies. Our first quarter church conference will be Tuesday. Will be this coming Tuesday. And so we need you to register, my brothers and sisters, so we can have you in place and you get the information for the meeting. So we want to do that first quarter church conference. So we thank God for that. Listen, there's so many employment opportunities that we have available. Please go to Tabernacle Baptist Church's website. You will see the various opportunities that are there. In particular, there are some janitorial opportunities at the Amazon warehouse that we want you to be on the lookout for with competitive pay. Our scholarships for college-bound students and continuing education students are still available. Please go to the website to apply. Remember, our cross-training classes are in session. If you are interested in registering, please email crosstrainingzoomtbc@gmail.com. This is important for Christian education. Please do so. Please be mindful that our clothing ministry is open Mondays 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. However, closed this coming Monday, so closed tomorrow for their services. Remember to sign up for text messages. We want to be able to keep in contact with you. Download the TBC app to get the latest, most up-to-date information. And remember, in all things we are going to in 2021, keep moving forward. And we want you to follow us, follow me on all our social media platforms. We want to stay connected to you. Amen. Amen. Tabernacle, it is offering time. It is offering time. It is offering time. We celebrate that here at Tabernacle. Bible says, giving, it will be given back to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, all in your lap. And we want you to smile because we know that God loves a cheerful giver. Get those gifts in your hand. You can go to your computer. You can go to your cell phone. Go to the TBC website, or you can go to the TBC app. Or you can text to give through Tithely. You can go to Givelify, type in Tabernacle Baptist Church, Burlington, New Jersey. Mail it in or bring it in, whatever is good for you. Again, brothers and sisters, we love you and we appreciate your consistency in giving. Let's go to the Lord. God, we thank you and we love you and we appreciate you. We thank you for the opportunity to go forth in worship. And God, it is our prayer that you bless us now in this moment. Lord, let the music ministry go forth one more time and the word come forth as well. For your people who give today, bless them for their faithfulness. And God, we pray that every gift be used for your kingdom. Thank you, God, in Jesus' name. Let the saints of God say amen and amen. God bless you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We come to bless him this morning.
Yes, Lord.
TBC, let your worship fill your home or wherever you are right now. Come on, let us just give words of adoration unto the Lord. Hallelujah. We love you, Lord. Worthy are you, God. You're holy, God. Receive us this morning. Hallelujah. We honor you and we adore you. Great is your name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, let's just talk to him here in one voice, everybody. I worship.
I worship. In the beauty of holiness, I lift my hands to you. For you are my righteousness. Royalty, so
Come on, let's sing that again, team. Come on, everybody.
I worship you. In the beauty of holiness, I lift my hands to you.
Let's sing this second verse. I reverence.
I reverence you.
Hey.
For holy, thou art holy.
Oh.
I bow to
thank you.
Family, take a moment. Take that moment.
Jesus.
You are royalty. King of kings. Your majesty. Take that moment, family. Acknowledge the God that you serve. Yeah, 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 yeah. God, we approach your throne. We approach you as king, as ruler. Above all, God, we approach you as the one true and living God. We thank you, majesty, royalty. Thank you. And we worship you. We call you worthy. You're worth it. Thank you, God. God, if you would, let us be just a portion to you of what you are to us. God, if we could just be a little bit to you of what you are to us. Thank you, God. Order our steps in your word. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen, brothers and sisters. We thank God for the word of God. Thank God for the word of God that speaks to us in music ministry. Thank you to this TBC team. We are so grateful for you today. My brothers and sisters, today I have a bit of, it may be a dense word. I want to do some teaching today. I don't know where this is going to go. I pray that you can follow it. But this passage of scripture, as we have been journeying through the book of Acts, it touched me. And in light of everything that we have seen in this world, the George Floyd case, where the verdict was given this week, to incidents around the country that remind us that our fight is not over, to the role of the church and God's people, in light of 8 years of pastoral ministry that we celebrated last week, what is the word? What is the word from the Lord? Dr. Francois reminded us last week that we just take it 1 week at a time. Like Noah sent that dove out and it came back. Wait 7 days, do it again. So if you would, brothers and sisters, I want you to turn with me to the book of Acts chapter 4. Book of Acts chapter 4, And again, it is my prayer that you follow us. And hopefully we learn the text and learn the message as well. Acts chapter 4, beginning in verse number 23 from New King James Version of the Holy Greek text. It says these words: "And being let go, they went to their own companions and reported all that the chief priests and elders had said to them. So when they heard that, they raised their voice to God with one accord and said, 'Lord, you are God, who made heaven and earth and the sea and all that is in them, who by the mouth of your servant David have said, why did the nations rage and the people plot vain things? The kings of the earth took their stand, and the rulers were gathered together against the Lord and against his Christ. For truly against your holy servant Jesus, whom you anointed, both Herod and Pontius Pilate with the Gentiles and the people of Israel were gathered together to do whatever your hand and your purpose determined before to be done. Now, Lord, look on their threats and grant to your servants that with all boldness," hear that, that's the primary text for today, "that with all boldness they may speak your word by stretching out your hand to heal, and that signs and wonders may be done through the name of your holy servant Jesus." And when they had prayed, the place where they were assembled together was shaken, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and they spoke the word of God with boldness. God bless you, brothers and sisters, for our time to share. I want to talk about a different kind of prayer. A different kind of prayer. Psalm number 2 is considered to be a royal psalm. As stated in that category, in that name, a royal psalm is about the king. Many of these royal psalms are also considered to be what they call messianic, in that they speak of the coming Messiah. Our Christian tradition interprets these to be in reference to Jesus of Nazareth. In particular, there's one part of Psalm 2 that stands out. It is verse number 7. It says these words: "I will declare the decree. The Lord has said to me, 'You are my son. Today I have begotten you.'" You may recognize that language, son and begotten, because it is reflected and quoted throughout the New Testament, John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son." Luke specifically quotes Psalm 2 in Acts chapter 13 with these words. It says, "He has fulfilled for us their children by raising Jesus, as also it is written in the second Psalm, 'You are my son, today I have begotten you.'" Hebrews chapter 1 paints the picture of God speaking and manifesting God's self through God's Son. The Son is exalted above the angels. In Hebrews 1 and 5, the writer says these words: "For to which of the angels did he ever say, 'You are my Son, today I have begotten you'?" One of the most beautiful portraits of the God, the Father, Jesus, the Son dynamic is found in Matthew chapter 3. Jesus comes from Galilee to John at the Jordan to be baptized. And when Jesus had been baptized, he came up immediately from the water and the heavens opened up to him. The Bible says the Spirit of God descended on him like a dove, and a voice from heaven said these words: "This is my beloved Son in whom I am well pleased." Another is found in the Transfiguration. While Peter was speaking, the text says that a bright cloud overshadowed them, and a voice came from heaven spoke these same words that were spoken at the Jordan River. This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. Each of these has language that is either quoting Psalm 2 or reminiscent of Psalm 2, this royal psalm that highlights the connection between the king and God. The king is considered to be a son to God, and because the king is this son to God, God looks highly upon the king. The king is anointed by God. This is started by King David. And you can see why Psalm 2 would also be considered messianic. Jesus is the Son of God. God is proud of God's Son, as evidenced by the words at the Jordan River and at the scene of the Transfiguration. Jesus is considered higher than the angels, as said in Hebrews, because God never said words of affection and relationship like this to any of the angels. So Psalm 2 is powerful and relevant for our discussion today, because in Acts chapter 4, verses 25 through 26, it is a direct reference to Psalm 2, verses 1 through 2. The suggestion is made that the Holy Spirit spoke through King David to write these words. Why did the nations rage and the people plot a vain thing? The kings of the earth set themselves, and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointed. Jesus, as we see, is the anointed one that the Psalms speak about in a messianic way. Jesus is the Messiah. Jesus is the Christ. And Acts identifies Herod and Pontius Pilate as the individuals that were against Jesus. This, brothers and sisters, cannot be disputed, because ultimately they signed off on Jesus's crucifixion. And the situation played out just like the psalmist said it would in Psalm 2. The kings of the earth took their stand, and the rulers were gathered together against the Lord and against his Christ. So between Psalm 2 and Acts 4, there is a clear indication that Jesus is the Messiah and Jesus is God's Son, and that the rulers, the kings, were against him. And this is where it gets interesting. Peter, John, and the rest of the Jesus followers are aligning themselves with this particular perspective. Because the elders and leaders were against Jesus, they interpret that as the leaders and the elders being against them. Because the kings and the government are against Jesus, that means that they, by definition, must be against them. That's heavy right there. Peter and John have identified a clear line of demarcation. If you are over there, that means you are against Jesus. And if you are against Jesus, then you're against what we're doing. If you're over there, then that means you're not in line with the Messiah. So that means you cannot be in line with what we're talking about. On the contrary, if you're over here, that means you stand with us and you stand for the gospel of Jesus the Christ. I love this. That means that the disciples have made a conscious decision. You're either for us or against us. And we are not concerned in the least bit if you are in a position of authority. We could care less if you are in high ranking. We are not concerned if you stand in places of prestige and power. If you stand against the message and ministry of Jesus the Christ, they are saying, we are willing to stand up and fight for our right to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ, and we will continue to preach the good news. We will continue to get folks saved, and we will continue to baptize in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of sins. We're going to do it anyhow. And I think that's the kind of attitude that Jesus is looking for in 2021, because, brothers and sisters, there is a lot of wrong out there. There's a lot of wrong in this world. We saw it this week. We've seen it for some time. Now, that's all right though. As long as Jesus has some saints that are willing to stand up even when wrong is all around, we've got to believe that everything will work itself out. Can I talk the way I should talk? Can I talk the way I want? Can I do the right thing when wrong is all around me? Can I act like I'm supposed to act when bad actions are all around me? Can I do what I'm supposed to do even when it costs me something? Can I stand on God's word even when it hurts? Can I speak truth even when there are consequences? That's what's really happening in Acts chapter 4. You have to remember where we are in the text. We are immediately following our last look at Acts chapter 4 when Peter and John had been arrested and brought before the council. They were forbidden from teaching in the name of Jesus. However, it was Peter and John that responded back and said these words, "We cannot keep from speaking what we have seen and heard." Text says, and the council ended up releasing them because the people saw that lame man from chapter 3 walking and were praising God because of what happened. So the council knew that they couldn't get the people on their side because the people just witnessed a man walking that had been lame for over 40 years. So here's where the text picks up. Peter and John go back to their friends, and they tell them about their experiences and how the chief priests and elders were annoyed and wanted to stop them from teaching in the name of Jesus Christ. And after Peter and John got with their friends, they decided to do something. They lifted their voices together and started praying. My God, today. After they got released from where they were forbidden from preaching and teaching in the name of Jesus, they get back to their friends and they start praying. But listen, it was not a prayer of thanksgiving. It was not a prayer of gratitude. This thing messed me up. It was another kind of prayer. I gotta admit, I did not read this passage and immediately celebrate Peter and John's response. I did not say to myself, look at how they responded. They prayed a different kind of prayer. The reality is, when I read this, this thing convicted me. I asked myself a question. If I was in that same position, would I have immediately gotten with my prayer partners and started praying this kind of prayer? And the answer to my inquiry was no. I probably would have prayed, and I probably would have celebrated being released. I probably would have thanked God for what just transpired. I might have even lifted my hands and given glory to God for everything that God had done. But would I have prayed this kind of prayer? The answer is no, because what kind of prayer is this that makes me feel like this? What kind of prayer did Peter and John pray that convicts my spirit? Because it would not have been the kind of prayer that I prayed. It's the kind of prayer that comes from a group of people that have aligned themselves with the Father God and the begotten Son represented in Psalm 2. They have aligned themselves with Jesus, who they believe Herod, Pilate, and the chief priests and elders are against. Look at what they say. Listen to their words. Lord, you are God, who made heaven and earth, and the sea, and all that is in them. Listen to their prayer. Who by the mouth of your servant David have said, why did the nations rage and the people plot vain things? The kings of the earth took their stand, and the rulers were gathered together against the Lord and against his Christ. For truly against your holy servant Jesus, who you anointed, both Herod and Pontius Pilate, with the Gentiles and the people of Israel, were gathered together to do whatever your hand and your purpose determined before to be done. Now, Lord, look on their threats and grant to your servants that with all boldness they may speak your word by stretching out your hand to heal, and that signs and wonders may be done through the name of your holy servant Jesus. They didn't just pray a prayer of thanksgiving. Their prayer differed from other prayers historically. If you go through the scriptures, prayer in these types of situations are prayers that ask God for deliverance or for help. Psalm 42 says, as the deer longs for the flowing streams, so my soul longs for you. Oh God, why are you cast down? Oh my soul, why are you disquieted within me? Hope in God, for I shall again praise him, my help and my God. Those are words that want God to deliver them, to help them. Psalm 51, create in me a clean heart. Renew within me a right spirit. And oftentimes we stop there, but if you keep going, you hear David say, deliver me from bloodshed, O God of my salvation, and my tongue will sing aloud your deliverance. David is asking God to help him and deliver him, but Peter and John didn't pray like this. They did not pray that God would deliver them from those that stood against them and did not want them to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. Their prayer was, Lord, you know what we are going through. Lord, you know what was done to Jesus. Lord, you know everything that's going on. So we're not asking you for deliverance. We're asking for the boldness to continue to speak your word. Oh, help me, Holy Ghost. That thing got to me. It convicted my spirit. Peter and John did not ask God to help them in their time of need. They asked God to give them what they needed so that they could continue to do the ministry that God had assigned for them to do. Lord, we're not asking you to get us out. We're asking for the boldness to keep on preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. In other words, watch this. Peter and John view preaching the gospel as their responsibilities. This is what they have been called and chosen to do. Jesus instructed them to do this. He told them that they would have power after the Holy Ghost has come upon them. They would be witnesses into all the world. They've been preaching this since chapter 2. They performed a miracle in chapter 3. They've been fulfilling their responsibilities. Now, Lord, if you would, give us the ability to continue doing what you told us to do. And God, if you do that, we are confident that all will be well. I know that's not a shouting word, but listen to me now. That's a word for the folk that have to deal with people that are blocking your assignment. That's a word for the folk that have to confront enemies on a daily basis. That's why I got so convicted when I read this text, because instead of spending my time asking God to deal with people, maybe my prayer ought to be for God to work with me so that I can continue to do what God has called me to do. Am I talking to somebody on today? Yes, yes, you may have an obstacle. You may even have some enemies. You may have folk that want to stop you. Before you spend all your time concerned about them, get with some folk and start praying, God, give me what I need to press through. Give me what I need to keep moving forward. Give me what I need to do what you have called me to do. There is an underlying implication in this prayer. It is, God, if you give us the boldness to preach your word, we know we don't have to ask you for deliverance. And the reason we won't have to ask you for deliverance is because you know the situation. And while we're praying for boldness, you'll already be too busy healing. You'll be too busy doing signs and wonders. You'll be too busy doing exceeding and abundantly above all we could ever ask or think. That's the power of prayer. We know that if we just preach your word, you'll handle the rest. If we just preach your word, you'll show up in such a way that people won't be able to deny it's you. I heard a preacher say this a while ago, and I wasn't sure I believed it at the time. But God showed me over time that what the preacher said was true. He said, you just step out and do what the Lord has called you to do, and God will handle the rest. Did you catch that? For all the folk out there worrying about stepping out on faith, did you catch that? For all the folk out there worrying about how things are going to work out, did you catch that? For all the folk out there that are tempted to throw in the towel and simply give up, did you catch that? This is a prayer of faith. God, if you give us the boldness to speak, we are confident that you will take care of the rest, and it does not matter what the enemies will do. It won't matter what the naysayers do. It won't matter what the doubters do. If we do what you called us to do, we are confident that you will handle it. That is a different kind of prayer. I'm here to let somebody know that that's the kind of prayer God answers. We're going to get out of here, musicians. Come on up, because we're going to get out of here. We're going to pray. It's a prayer that says, we have the faith to do what you want us to do. And we know that when we do what we're supposed to do, you'll step out ahead of us and do what you always do. Listen, y'all, that's the end of the sermon right there. I ain't deep today. I'm not going all in like that today. That's the message. The message is that God answers those kinds of prayers. Acts chapter 4 verse 31 says, when they had prayed, the place where they were assembled together was shaken, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit. Watch this now. And spoke the word of God with boldness. Because God is a God that answered prayer. They prayed for boldness, and God answered them and gave them boldness. I want to, brothers and sisters, I want to lead us in a spiritual exercise. I know this is different. I know this is, what's up with Pastor? Ain't nothing up with me. This is what we need to do today. I want to lead us in a spiritual exercise. Can we participate collectively in this virtual space? Can we participate in a different kind of prayer? I want us to pray together, but the prayer won't be a typical prayer. So I want you to do something for me right now. I want you to bow your head. I want you to close your eyes, or whatever posture of prayer that you have. If that's getting down on your knees, you shouldn't have any problem. You're at home. Getting in your secret place. Whatever you need to do, I want you to get in your posture of prayer right now. And I want to pray together these words. Lord, some of us have faced some significant challenges. Lord, some of us have had to deal with some hard roadblocks. Lord, some of us have people connected to us that don't want us to succeed. Give us the boldness to press toward the mark. Give us the boldness to walk in our destiny. Give us the boldness to live out our call. Give us the boldness to not be intimidated and to look the devil in the face and claim that we are more than conquerors. God, give us boldness. We know that you go before us. We know that you go ahead of us. And we know you've already done the miracle. You've already won the battle. You've already done what you said you would do. So God, we thank you. Thank you for this different prayer. Thank you for this prayer that has power. Thank you in advance for boldness. In Jesus' name. So that means, child of God, you go forth. In whatever you believe God has called you do it with boldness. Just like Peter and John did what they felt they had to do in the midst of the leaders and the elders. You go forth and do what God has placed in your heart to do. And you do it not being afraid of what anybody will do to you. That's our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Family, there may be someone here today who needs Jesus Christ in your life. We encourage you, whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. The door of the church is always open for you. The door of the church is always open for you. If you're here and you want to be baptized, you want to be saved, you want to change your life, or if you're here and you want to connect with this village called Tabernacle, or if you have gone astray and gotten disconnected from any type of ministry, it's your opportunity to come. Feel free to reach out to our deacons ministry. They will connect with you. You can reach out either phone or email, and it will be our pleasure to speak with you and to make sure you find yourself connected. My brother, my sister, we had a different experience today. And it's my prayer that you understand what Peter and John prayed about. It wasn't a whole lot of jumping and shouting at that point in the scripture. Yes, there's a time to jump and shout, but that wasn't it. There wasn't dancing in the streets. Yes, we see in the scriptures of dancing in the streets, but that wasn't the time. In that moment, they said, God, we have seen some obstacles already, and what we need is continued boldness to keep on doing what you've called us to do. That's my prayer for you today, that God would grant you that. And now unto him who is able to keep us from falling, to prevent us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forevermore. And the people of God say amen, amen, and amen. Please, brother and sister, go in peace and go in boldness in Jesus' name.
Bear all things to